Alright, welcome back, boys and girls. I am going to show you how to play the song Vitamin from the album Science. First of all, the song is in standard E tuning, which is pretty self-explanatory. If you don't know what that is, Google guitar standard E tuning and then come back. Welcome back. So I use quite a lot of foot pedals in this song. I've got this super phaser set at a really slow rate. I've got this phaser set at a slightly higher rate, not fast, but higher, but faster. And I've also, there are different modes. This one has mode 2 and this one has mode 1 set, so they just sound different from each other. The gonculator I use quite a lot in the song. Reverb is pretty much used throughout. This delay pedal I have set actually at kind of a fast sound. And you'll see why I have that. I use it in the verses. And then I've got this MXR phaser. It's kind of set in the middle, which is, you know, not fast, not slow, just sort of in the middle. I use the envelope filter during the bridge of the song. And yeah, I think that does it. Well, I've actually also got this overdrive pedal on my clean channel, just kind of set up a little bit, just gives the clean channel a little bit of extra bite. Alright, so I will start now with how to play the intro of the song. Up here on the 7th fret of the A string, I usually use my ring finger for this. The general placement of the notes is using your ring finger on the 7th fret here, and then your first finger and your ring finger on the 3rd and 5th frets. So the riff sounds like this. And I generally try to let the open E string ring out as I'm playing this, so. Or at least when I'm playing it when it's heavier. In the very beginning, I've kind of muted it up a little bit. So at the very beginning of the song, I've got this slow phaser, really, you know, kind of an extreme. The depth and the resonance are set really high. So it sounds like this, and I've got a little bit of reverb on it. You'll recognize that from the recording. This is pretty much exactly what I used as far as the effects go. Different guitar, different amps or whatever, but it should sound similar enough. And then when the song gets heavy, it's the same riff, it's just played a little more aggressively, like. So that's the intro, and then right before the first verse starts, I play this chord up here where I've got my first finger on the 10th fret of the G string, the 11th fret of the B string, and the 12th fret of the high E string, and I'm just doing this. And this is where I kick on my sort of slower phaser, my faster phaser pedal. So the verse section is probably the most challenging part to play, at least for me in the song, just because of, you know, I have to get I manually set the delay pedal, so it's a challenge sometimes getting it to the right tempo. So I'm kind of, it's kind of creating this ping pong effect. So it's like this, and I have the MXR phaser set pretty much a little slower, actually, like set here. During this part of the song, and I usually have the reverb on as well. I'm playing this pattern, my first finger up here on the 4th fret of the G string, and then my ring finger, I prefer to use my ring finger for whatever reason, on the 5th fret of the B string, and I'm just going up and down in half steps. What it sounds like with the effects on it is kind of cool. So you got to play it in time with the delay, and it's like this. sometimes if I'm feeling adventurous, I'll throw the envelope filter in there as well. So instead of just hearing it like this, it sounds like this. Pretty cool. Okay, so now I'm going to teach you how to play the chorus of Vitamin, which is based on the intro riff, just a couple of power chords thrown in there. It starts up here on the 7th fret of the A string, start off with my ring finger, and then I also come down here to play my play the C note on the 3rd fret of the A string with my first finger and my ring finger. So you're kind of just playing these notes in here and then here as well. You're kind of, this is your, that's the general vicinity of this whole riff. So it starts up here. So you go to G power chord and then to an F power chord and then 3rd fret to the 5th fret. 5th fret, 5th fret to the 7th fret. So that all chained together, played slowly, sounds like this. Leading up into the bridge, I go back to playing this chord here, which we'll call the tritone chord. 10th, 11th, and 12th fret on your top 3 strings. You can see this here. Should sound like that. Kick on my super phaser. Just let that ring for a while the other guys are doing their thing. Jose's rocking, you know, Ben's rocking, Brandon's rocking. And then this is actually kind of similar to what I do in Redefine. And I don't know if I explained this very well during Redefine, but when I have the gonculator pedal on, a lot of times I'm just strumming open strings. It's real, you know, I've got this thing set in such a way that it's really dissonant sounding. So in this song, I'm just playing. I'm not hitting any notes, I'm just, you know, strumming open strings. Sounds kind of like a mess, which is fun. So the part that comes in after that, I switch over to the envelope filter. And a lot of times I'll actually leave my MXR phaser on for this too. And that riff that I'm playing during this part, during the bridge, it starts up here on the 7th fret of the A string, and then the 9th fret of the G string, and I'm playing an octave here. So this whole part is built on octaves. So it's like this. Second half of it, I turn off my effects and I click over to the dirty channel, but I'm gonna stay on the clean channel just so you can hear what it sounds like. After that, I switch back over to, I turn on my super phaser, the really slow one, with the reverb on it, and then I go back to this. It's basically just a reintro. It's the beginning of the song played all over again. And I play. And then there are a couple of times in amongst that part where I just play an E power chord like this. And there are these big, you know, tom, you know, hits, and we just lock up. That's it. Just a high E power chord. get the fourth down underneath there on the seventh fret of the low E string, kind of thickens up the chord. And then I play the chorus again and the song is over. So there you have it. Teaching you is New Skin, which I know is going to be exciting for you guys. It's exciting for me to share it with people because that's probably, of all the songs on this album, I've probably been asked the most about New Skin. So that's for next time. See you soon.